The protesters angry over the impact of logging in the Oak State Forest near Barraville.
This latest standoff follows recent clashes between police and protesters who say there's not been sufficient consultation between forestry and green groups over the logging of Compartment 375. They're angry at the fact logging has started before an environmental impact statement is completed. State Forests want to log 20 hectares of the 287-hectare compartment. Following recent protests and damage caused to a grader, the department closed the forest to the public.
It's not a course of action that we like to take, but in this instance, the conservationists were running around in the operation and making a danger of themselves, getting in under felled trees, and we were left with no option but to close the forest for their safety.
But landowners and action groups claim logging will impact severely on one of the catchment's remaining sources of drinking water, despite forestry's claim of minimal risk.
How many times have forestry said that before? And Killer Cranky, which is only a few kilometres away from where they are, they logged that a few years back, and the EPA have just taken them to the cleaners for it, for gross negligence.
Green groups say they've uncovered evidence of 10 rare and endangered species near the logging site and rainforest near the disputed area.
The only snig track or logging road that they've pushed into the forest at the moment is over 27 degrees heading straight for Little Wonder Creek. There's going to be a hell of a lot of soil that moves into Little Wonder Creek the very next time it rains.
The situation became heated after one protester scaled the forestry building. Police were then called in.
Our locals are watching trucks coming out both ways from that compartment at night. Now, can you explain to us why that's happening?
Eventually, they were forced to remove their banners, but with little consensus achieved today, it appears the standoff will continue for some time yet. Frank Bonacorso, 10 News.
Coming up, more damning evidence in the O.J. Simpson murder case, and a showdown on the high sea.
Of Little Wonder, beautiful rainforest. Of Little Wonder near Barraville, south of Bellingen. We are scouting, mapping, surveying endangered species, preparing for a possible future blockade, and having a hell fun time. Our tribe consists of the local Kuris, us, and anyone else who wants to come along.
Groovy. I reckon forest dwellers, right down in there somewhere.
That's yeah, forest dwellers.
Us forest dwellers.
Yeah.
Us forest dwellers.
The green Anzacs.
Okay.
Yeah, sort of a holiday. The non-blockade. NEFA announces the non-blockade. Come and visit. Take a walk on the wild side.
Pretty amazing place, Little Wonder, eh?
Yeah. Anyway, we'll have to get sort of relaxed in.
So what's all this native title legislation mean to you, Bill?
Native title legislation. Okay. Well, that's, in actual fact, it doesn't really mean nothing to me. But native title legislation, I mean, living in this world, everything's got to be bloody legal shit and all that crap and all on paper. So native title legislation in that sense, you know, is good, because at least we've got a chance of saying we own something. But, like I say, you know, why the fuck should we have to sign papers to say, and then to say that we actually got this permission to have this land off these bifollows, you know what I mean? Things like that. But native title, if we can get all the land we need, yeah, I don't mind, and, you know, all the state forests and everything else that isn't used by the govos.
What would you do with it, you reckon?
Nothing, mate. Just live in there. Live off the land and just live there.
He's still Bowie.
Oh, fuck yeah. He's ready.
Last time I was out here, it was raining and it was...
Yeah, fire.
Coming in.
Yeah, fire.
Come on, Davis, go and get the wood.
Better?
Build the fire now.
It's nice. That's good.
Reoccupying the forest rather than simply protesting about them, right? So you know, yeah, we've got a voice in them because we're actually a voice in them.
Yeah, and in particular this place, because it's so easy to get to, good roads, we can announce the non-blockade and invite everyone to come and have a look at this patch.
There's interest from, you know, local Koori land claim and
forest dwellers
and plans to build the forest dwelling, you know.
According to the High Court decision, no one can claim national park and no one can claim beachfront. The only decent sized bits of land left that aren't postage stamps, from what we can see, are these state forests, as you can see here.
Well, you know, like, I'm up here now with you dudes and you just do your thing to stop all this forestry fucking shit going on. Like, you know what I mean? It don't matter what you do, you're governed by the big fella anyway, what you call Big Brother. I mean,
even out here, you reckon?
Well, he'll be here sooner or later if he knows you're here. He's going to send some rep out here.
And if he sees that there are people here who are entitled to claim it under native title, what do you reckon he'll do then?
Look, mate, he makes the laws, he's got the courts. He can do exactly what he fucking wants, you know? Exactly. And whatever he says, that rep could say it. I could say get fucked and still live here, you know what I mean? Which I would, but he could still do that. And in this society, like, then I'm a criminal, you know what I mean? Or some sort of fucking antagonist, some crap like that, you know what I mean?
So on the one hand, like, you know, you can't trust any of the paperwork because the governments can change tomorrow.
Of course they can.
And on the other hand, like, really the only way to make any connection with the place is to actually be out here.
Yeah, well, the only way, in my lifetime, the only way I'm going to be Aboriginal is come out here and fucking be Aboriginal, you know what I mean? Just do it myself. Who gives a fuck about who, permission and all that crap? That's the only way I'm going to do it in my lifetime, you know. But it'd be good if you had a fucking, like, a little tribe out here, like, hey.
Hi, man.
How's it going?
Thank you.
little game of chicken. Oh, rhubarb. We should have put the rhubarb in with it. It's real.
I don't understand how this tree could still be alive. Like with this fig growing in it.
Oh, no, this tree is the fig. And the other tree that was in the centre of the fig has rotted away and it's gone. And that's why you've got the hollow fig with the staircase going up the centre.
Yeah, but the original tree's dead.
Yeah, but any other trees can grow into it. These figs, this might be three or four different figs all growing together. If you have a look, all of the branches and all of the trunk and all of the vines hanging down, they go out of the tree and into the tree in a number of different places. You can't tell what's a branch and what's a root that's dropping down and reforming into itself. And for that reason, there are many trees. Many of these strangler figs are actually three or four different figs that have grown together.
Right, so that's what you call the tree.
The tree of life, this one.
It's really hollow and there's heaps of little crevices everywhere, and you can imagine the million and one things living in here and things they get up to, you know, small little germs to giant things like me.
It's the inertia of actually getting people up and living in the forest and living in any camp is so great that actually setting up the forest camp in the first place is a real hassle.
Yeah.
You know, but once you've got people who are used to living there, again, in a central location, we can dive off to Wild Cattle Creek, we can dive off to Way Way, we can go to Nulla 5 Day, anywhere.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
The hatchet's gonna fall. It's coming down. Look, we're sick of it. We gotta get back to the bush, back to our old ways. It's just, town sucks. Everything in there sucks. Grog, fucking police. Every shit in there. There's only pubs in town. That's all you fucking see on the corners. Lads staggering around, all the boys. I'd rather see them out here, partying up, fucking build themselves a teepee or do something, instead of sitting around in town doing nothing, it's the usual thing over and over again. plus they ripping the shit out of all this forest and getting away with it. And no one's saying anything. No one along the coast is, look, it's only the greenies, you know, it's only them greenies, you know, all these greenies, that's about all. There's no blacks out there fighting for what are we supposed to be fighting for? The land, what's on the land? Fucking forest, eh? That's what we should be fighting for, is our forest back. Not this shit like a $60,000 block of fucking land in town. That's full of shit. You just gotta build a house there and they gotta wreck the bastard anyway. Why fight for that? We can fight for the lot. Shove it up a lot of them. It's all our land, they know it. They know where it came from, who was here first.
Might as well start fighting for something decent.
What's out here?
We have a plethora of
very, very tasty,
very tasty little food here. We just call them purple berries, because that's indeed what they are.
They taste like the colour purple. This one particularly should be very sweet, I think.
Show us that again.
Wow.
They are really tasty. Try them. If you could do anything you wanted to here now.
If I could do anything I wanted to here now, maybe I'd set this up as a decent base camp for anyone who'd want to run back and forwards in and out of town just for getting their own personal peace of mind out of it. Everything's out here, our industry, the whole of Australia is based around our logging industry and everything. That was the first industry here, when the white man got here. First thing they saw was all our trees. Said, ah, fuck, look at all this. Hey, take all this shit, no one's using it. These black fellas not using it.
So what are these then?
Scats.
What sort of scats are we looking at?
Dunno, chivals, considered chivals, that's from Yellow Belly. And the scat behind it, this is the one that Renner's playing with, has got seeds and insects in it as well. So it could be an owl or something. I don't know about the little ones, maybe a sugar glider.
Are these all found around here?
Yep, just in the next new track.
Scat analysis is still one of the best evidences, eh? It's pretty hard to get photos of it.
There and it's tangible and all this of it.
Yeah.
The only thing is proving where it came from. No, we got closer!
You know, those trees there, that's a natural resource, a tree. A living thing, that's a natural resource. How many houses can you build out of one of these trees and that? You get a fair few beams and that, but you're not going to get much out of them. And you can't just replant them straight away and just sprout them up overnight like anything, like corn and that. Corn only grows over a season. Trees, how long does trees grow? Thousands of years nearly. And it's not worth just reaping it all out now when it's only just starting to grow back. You can see by the way they've stuffed this log dump, they've left everything laying around.
Well, it's like obviously you've got heaps of cleared space and you've got like lots of, all of it's compacted, the soil's really going to be difficult to regenerate, it's going to take some intensive work.
I mean, it's an interesting part of the forest because it's taking the forest back to a very early succession stage, like this is like raised to the ground, most of the topsoil's gone, there's very few seeds left in the topsoil in the bank as a seed bank or anything, so that's it even makes an interesting part in the forest, a part where you can come in and see different stages and different sort of diversity.
How it copes.
But literally 100 metres from here, there's full-on, complete canopy rainforest.
Mm. which is marching up the slope towards it at a rate of knots.
Right. Yeah, right, you'd be hacking it back with the brush hooks just taking out.
No, it's, everyone might scare people if it sounds like the Barachan tribe, like, you know?
So is that your latest scunning job? What is it?
A blue-tongued lizard I found on the road.
Metal ones are about.
Rena the murderer.
The skinner.
And the patty melon's gone a bit stiff. That's because we didn't have any salt up here to salt it straight away.
What's that on?
Redneck patty melon. Respect redneck patty melons. Which means there must be heaps of them now.
Have the gardens running through here, down to the, like, obviously using, like, this little clearing, nothing from what's already cleared, and then come back through here with native bush tucker, home culture food forest. You can, I mean, obviously the teepees and everything here are appropriate sort of dwellings to, for people to be able to use, you know, all the time. It's obviously, you'd have to get a lot of mulch from somewhere, probably need to plant some sort of cover crop in here, in some way to, or use what's existing here at the moment to mulch the soil, and probably need to do things like de-rip the area, which is, you know, severely degraded. The soil's obviously gone from this particular spot. It's been really heavily industrially used.
So this was a log dump, yeah?
Yeah, it's a log dump shop.
Perfect village site there, really.
That's what permaculture's all about, is creating soil. If the people who want to live here, if the people, you know, people whose land this is, want to live here sustainably, then I guess that'll need to be done. All those things will need to be, like, food and materials provided from the site, and the most efficient way of actually being here. So, yeah, I don't know, that's what I reckon.
It won't matter who's black, white, brindle. As long as you don't bring your hassles out here, it's no problem. When you're out here, it's a survival trip. There's thousands of ways to die out here. You can die in rot and no one will find you ever. You'll end up with this mulch on the ground. You gotta be on a survival trip to be out here. Back to where you come from, or where everyone, your ancestors mainly, our ancestors came from, everyone's all the same, all primitive ancestors, whether we come from caves or fucking whatever.
Deep forests.
That's right. Forests or deserts, we practically all survive the same way. That was fine water. Best way we can.
What for?
Why?
making some clay beads.
What a stupid question.
Making some clay beads to hang
I'm
in my hair.
I'm making bowls and stuff.
Right. And give to other people.
So where'd you get the clay?
Out of this very ground here.
And Shakira, natural, what are you...
Good natural clay, you know. Make good use of it. Should bring all the kids up from down the cities and show them how to do this.
How to play with clay.
It's actually the ancient Peruvian coffee method. Very effective in bead making.
Oh my god. Straight out of the ground.
I'm gonna check if my flower's on fire.
Here, it might be really hot as well.
This is an extra big bead for your hair.
Nah, it's right. It's still not. Ready. It looks ready, but it's not.
Well, we're able to make our own marbles.
Hence the one in the fireplace at the present moment.
Ta-da! No, it's...
we hope that it won't crack.
We can make everybody look pretty.
Do you want to use that one there for teaching people?
What?
I think I'll put this one on.
Okay.
And teach people how to do this.
Yep, that'd be good.
That's a good idea. Okay.
So now you just need to tighten that up.
Before you start playing.
You can just walk yourself backwards down the tree.
And water.
Way back.
All those children everywhere.
People in Mayfield. It's so much lead in the air. It's going to just say a prayer. No, they're not going anywhere. They're going to live and die in Mayfield.
I've never heard why the word said they're missing out on the two main.
And you grow your crop, you can only grow your corn for so many seasons, and the earth's given up on the corn then. And then you got to grow something else. Or redo that soil all over again. And that's just costing big money, isn't it?
Now, how's that work
there's
up in the forest?
There's nothing there.
How's that work up in the forest then? When the soil's gone, it's not going to come back from anywhere up here on tops of the mountains.
That's right. It's not coming back up here. Once you cut the trees down and the undergrowth goes, all this lantana and shit moves in. And that's the end of that. That's what stays here, all lantana. That's all we walk around, blackberries and lantana. Full of shit everywhere.
Yeah. I reckon grow the introduced stuff in the crap forest and keep this forest as native as we can and try and keep the genetic, because this area's got a gene pool of its own which is independent from anywhere else, and if you bring in
very special,
if you bring in new genes, you're interfering totally with like the evolution of the area.
Yeah.
It's like turning something which is progressing in a natural fashion into something which has suddenly had this huge interference factor pushed into it.
So you can make a reasonable sort of assessment of whether your plants that you're bringing in are going to become a biological hazard to the area, or whether they're just going to enhance the diversity and give, you know, an extra niche. You know?
Yeah, but I just still think about it in terms of like those plants are the ones which are in the area are the natives to that area, and you're still like you've really got to consider whether or not you would ever have gotten this thing in there naturally. Mm. Like, otherwise you really get, like, you just, it's changing.
And how can
things.
You tell that?
Well, by assessing what sort of vectors
among the vectors are human vectors. I mean, what we're talking about is people reoccupying these places, and you know, and those people would have had contact with other people who would have traded all sorts of things with each other, and there would have been all sorts of ways in which useful and valuable seed sources could have moved from place to place.
The coons around here wouldn't have, like, if they did live here, they'd be off harvesting the fruits of the forest where they grow, not actively doing the agriculture.
Bunya pines are good.
Which is what you're talking about.
Bunya pines, example.
They definitely, cultivated and carried down the coast and planted.
Mm. That's basically the bottom line of my attitude, is that, you know, because it hasn't been done before and because it's not... something which is an accustomed practice, you know, we're abandoning a lot of accustomed practice, we're actually challenging accustomed practice in challenging the Forestry Commission, and we're also in some ways challenging accustomed practice for Koori traditions, in the sense that we don't want to start a forestic culture in the forest anymore, and you know, we are working towards some idea of a rainforest regeneration, pretty much, you know, wherever there's regeneration taking place.
But up here in Coffs Harbour after the recent fires, you know what the Coffs Harbour Council initiative was?
banned planting tree trees. Planting.
For 3 months.
Wow. Good one, Coffs.
On ya, guys.
They're leading us into the 21st century.
I'm not against introducing them in areas which are trashed. I'm just scared of... Like, because this is exactly the same mistakes which people made 200 years ago when they were sitting there going, well, I think I'll have a lantana hedge now, or a privet hedge or something.
Those,
like.
Those were actually introduced consciously into the country, but, you know, like it was...
Acclimatisation societies.
Assimilation societies. Yeah, they were deliberately introducing weeds to civilise the landscape.
Yeah.
You know, the guy that introduced the rabbit got killed in a hunting accident about 5 years after he introduced it.
That's good karma.
Hopefully it was lingering.
His brother or something shot him.
Oh, he's been a close family.
We can go and ask
our elders about the place and everything. And if they tell us we're not allowed to go somewhere, we won't send anyone there, or we won't go there. Like, the loggers won't go in there, or the greenies won't go in there, because we'll say, no, he's not allowed in there, and we're not allowed in there. That'll be the end of that. No one will be in there for the next... till hell freezes over. Who gives a shit?
Hey, you got one go good, eh?
That doesn't work, I'll just sing out the ma.
That's a Gawango Gaba Guya for you. Crazy white fella.
Pretty safe.
You can have the koalas.
Yeah, especially considering that we've got League Scrub just up the road, which is a flora reserve, which is like... yeah, but it looks nice. It's got a lot of species in it, a lot of tree species, like, which will, in time, spread into the neighbouring areas. And if you speed it along, like, you know, you might be squeezing out something which takes that extra 10 years to grow. Like, you're putting in a seedling, which is a... you know, go crazy and be 20 feet tall and fade out. You know,
yeah,
like,
yeah, a lot of important stuff, yeah.
Yeah, this one here's a red cedar for sure. Coachwood. See what this one is?
Yeah, walk down there to your dad's guy.
White Beach, this one.
That's White Beach.
On the edge of the reserve. And just here too, look at these ones. Look at that. And here we have massive red cedars, a stand of them. Right next to coachwood.
Extremely tall.
Whoa.
And white and black booyongs. And giant stinging trees.
A dozen houses. Lovely grain.
Recycled houses.
Trees are already dead. You don't need to cut them down.
Australian people that don't give a fuck are too comfortably numb anyway.
Comfortably numb's a damn good description. But
it is. So you say we're gonna claim all this coastal crown land. A lot of people like to go fishing there and like to go camping there and whatnot. That's fine. We don't want to stop that. What we're going to do is keep it a native title. No one's going to take it away from anybody. It's not going to be sold. It's not going to be... All we want is the right management plan for it that guarantees the local white people can use it as much as we. With a special area.
As long as it's not abused.
Yeah. And so the local people can see how they're going to benefit from native title, local white people. Instead of decisions being made in Sydney and wherever else about this bit of land, it'll be made locally and in consultation with local people.
Shit is talking shit.
Oh no, I reckon that there's a vast number of people that don't do anything at all. And it only takes a small number of people to actually change anything, so long as they're all pulling in similar directions.
So long as they've got the same vision.
if I'm going to be arrested, I'm going to have fun. It only took them 3 hours to process it.
That's a strange bike.
Yeah, it's been quite a few cars and bikes. Croppers.
Croppers.
Croppers, yeah.
Croppers are back.
It's that time of year. Gotta go out there and do this up.
Nub, you heard what happened to Jamie last week, didn't you?
Yeah.
What happened to Jamie? Oh, yeah, it's fine.
What happened?
Yeah, be a bit careful going off into the bush on Horseshoe Road, not on Mackay's, because that's sort of privately owned land, 500 metres down to the road, but they claim that as theirs. And Jamie, my car broke down and was parked about 15 k's from here. And we heard this car, combi, coming up here, and it didn't quite make it to the camp. And it turned around and drove back down, and he must have parked near my car, thinking it was somewhere down there, and got up in the morning and went for a walk in the bush and crossed an electronic trip wire, which went beeping, and two guys in balaclavas and camo gear came out with shotguns. No, it's only one. Was it only one?
One.
Yeah.
And
held him up and then took his photo.
Little disposable camera.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, pretty heavy scene then.
But, you know, it's also a wise move not to go wandering off on your own anywhere. Try going in pairs at least if you're going for walks, for instance.
Get lost together, it's far more fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure is.
Has anyone seen any animals or anything interesting that we can record on radio?
Toward the end of last year, I saw a juvenile koala about this big. No, hang on. This big, probably. What? Just when I was waking up, it almost tripped over my sleeping bag. So I stood really, lay there really, really still and watched it for about 20 minutes, trying out all the trees. And I saw another koala crossing from this compartment to the other one, holding across the road from 375 to 374. And let's see, all sorts of snakes, diamond pythons, carpet pythons. Red belly, black and brown, copperheads.
Rainforest snake too.
What's that?
Rainforest snake.
Rainforest snake, yeah. Number of dragons.
And these are all in the compartment.
Valley dragon, yeah, all in this compartment.
Wedge-tailed eagle.
Yeah, wedge-tailed eagle flew over the other night.
Black orange.
That was pretty good. Yeah, various black cockatoos. Yellow-tailed and red-tailed.
Species.
Yeah, fairly endangered. I mean, they're all threatened by habitat destruction, definitely. Yeah, you hear a lot of gliders from here, especially yellow-bellied, and a lot of sugar gliders.
Paddy melons.
Yeah, paddy melons. Redneck paddy melons.
Palmer wallabies.
Palmer wallabies, yeah. Rock wallabies even.
Betongs.
Yeah, I've seen betongs out on the road. A few of them. What else?
And so, like, all of these animals are endangered. They're on the Schedule 12, most of them.
Most of them are on Schedule 12, yeah.
And they're all right here in the first compartment that they want to log in this area.
Yep, I've seen them all.
There's National Parks and Wildlife done surveys up here?
No, they haven't. I wrote a letter to them the other week suggesting it.
Did you reply back from them?
No, I haven't.
They're trying to work out what the criteria for assessing old-growth forests is. And they're trying to do that for about 5 years. And they're no closer to getting a definitive set of criteria for defining old-growth.
And meanwhile, the forest is cut down?
Yeah.
But the North East Forest Alliance and others have come out with identifiably repeatable criteria for all forest typing and old-growth typing, and this has been widely accepted scientifically. It just hasn't been accepted by forestry or national parks yet.
Mm. Seems like it's almost just a tactic to allow them to keep logging while they keep on putting out papers.
Yeah, that's right. Keep it ambiguous.
Mm. Yep. Keep the debate going.
Yep.
Meanwhile, it's really nothing to debate.
Yeah. wider where we live when the forest's gone. Potteroos, where will you live when the forest's gone? Greater gliders, where will you live when the forest's gone? You can see that there's rainforest if you open your eyes, but the maps are all full of corporate lies. Forest-dwelling humans, where will you live when the forest's gone? Rufus Batons, where will you live when the forest's gone? Antikinas, where will you live when the forest's gone? You can see that there's rainforest if you open your eyes, but the maps are all full of corporate lies.
Well, if you want to point your camera backwards and up, you'll see a branch in the huge white mahogany, possibly, might be a...
tallow, it's probably a tallow wood.
Possibly a tallow wood. It's the other technique for getting up the trees. Fling an arrow with a compound bow with a piece of fishing line or string attached between the two. Get the line over, then tow the two climbing ropes just here over with the string, and you lash one end off and you climb the other. Is it clear in the hair?
No, clear as it can get.
Fall.
Bases a lot of their maps on very old aerial photos, and they haven't taken into account a lot of the quirks of aerial photos, such as senescent trees are often understated from aerial photos. A lot of them you can't pick up from the shape of the crown.
Old trees.
Old trees, things like that. Run up and down different ways.
What are you making, Harry?
A lot of them
spider web.
Difficult.
You're making what?
Spider web.
Actually, one
put a spider on. Hang from a tree.
That was actually quite a good way. I haven't found it exactly.
What do you reckon, Bill? You remember times around here, around Barrowville, when segregation was still happening?
Yeah.
What was it like in Barrowville?
Well, I didn't actually know it was segregation when it was segregation. When I was young, we had to go in the down the side door of the picture theatre. We weren't allowed to sit in the seats.
What, you had to sit in the aisles?
No, down the front.
Down the front, on the floor.
Like, we didn't know it was segregation. I realised what it was. And the old people never had a word. Never had that word to use.
Yeah.
It's only a recent word, isn't it, really?
Wouldn't have been in the original tongue here, eh?
No, again.
Wouldn't have been in the original language here.
Well, I wouldn't have even thought of. You know, it's only a white conception.
What else around town? How about the pubs and places like that?
Well, I was too young for pubs and too young to know much about them, too. But what I do know, what I have been told, is they had to have cards to be in town. And them cards allowed them to buy grog and shit, but that's only the couriers that were white, that licked ass. Eh? The couriers that were black weren't allowed near any anyway.
And where did they have to stay?
Well, they just didn't give a fuck about town, so they stayed down the river or at the mission. Eh?
So your dad told you about the freedom rides through this area too, yeah?
Yeah, he rode the buses through here, through Coffs Harbour and all that shit.
And what were the freedom buses?
They were the buses that protested for the, for the rights of the blacks not to have separation. What is it? Like the South African rights. What is it?
Apartheid.
Yeah, the apartheid rights. Same shit. It's still happening here today, but it's on a more conservative scale. Like, they don't show it as much, but there's a lot more hatred in Barra than what people show. It's there. And in the early days, they showed it by keeping them out of the pubs. Like Bill Jack said earlier, but it was only certain people allowed in there. People with tickets and that. Fancy carrying a ticket down the street to say that you're allowed in the street. That white man, look, he had to walk off the gutter sometimes. If a white woman was walking up the street, black fella had to walk off the bloody side onto the road and let her walk past. That's the way it was. These days, it's starting to get, with the alternative lifestyle that's kicked in all over the place, it's getting a bit better. But still, there's those rednecks in town, and that's why I don't like town. It just sucks, you know?
So you reckon it'd be good to have a big space where the local brothers and sisters could go, where they didn't have to feel that sort of pressure then, eh?
This is what, we want to build something like that here, where they can come and, like I said, have their own peace of mind, get away from whatever they want to get away from, anyone, you know? No one's going to come up here hassling them. Anyone can come up here. It's everyone's land. All we want is it back for us to have a bit of say in what's happening to it. We don't want it ending up like this shit here on the pile here behind us.
The CIA is in the lobby. The CIA is in the hall. The CIA is in the lobby. The CIA sees and knows all.
So what the district forester say then?
I don't know, he just reckons it's just a joke, putting in this claim.
The claim for the state forest is just a joke?
Yeah, it's just a joke that Steve raising.
And what does he think that... So he doesn't think you're serious about actually claiming the land back?
Yeah.
Did he say anything to you about the greens as well, generally?
Oh, no. Just us, a bunch of greens, exciting the couriers. Getting the couriers excited. It's just another backward redneck. Redneck views.
And that's the letter he put to the Lands Council. Yeah. That's his response to the land claim so far.
I laughed.
Well, that someone did.
He's a laugh.
I just told Eddie he was a very sick man. It's a sick world.
Jara went to school with him.
But then the government tear down fucking 200 acre trees and send you a piece of paper saying, you know, you're sitting in the wrong spot, mate.
That's a big vine.
Wow, look at that.
Thank you.
And we got back into town and found out that a forestry commission grader doing horseshoe had been vandalised. And the headlights were smashed and the instrument panel was smashed and the hydraulic hoses had been disconnected. The main suspects in this crime were a white combi and a woman with a ring through her lip. So we spun out and went, oh, wow, that's us. Thank Christ we're at Bundagent. Driving a fucking incredibly noisy car. Because a few days previously, we'd been in the mistake in compartment 357. Just sussing it out. We arrived there and sort of spoke with a forestry dude and he said, keep 200 metres away from that machine, where's your hard hat? Rah, rah, rah. We said, look, we're not here to blockade, we just want to have a look at what you've... Where have you been working? Down there. So we thundered off down these fucking erosion gullies all the way into the bottom of the compartment, found a few trees with scratches on them that had been felled and...
What, koala scratches?
Koala scratches with, yeah. So there was one of them lying on the ground with a big red spot on it and scratches all over it.
So they'd cut down obvious koala trees and they'd marked them right over the scratches.
So the marker right in the middle of the scratches.
So the marker obviously knew that they were koalas.
Probably not.
But
is the marker trained in koala scratch identification?
So they're either incompetent or corrupt.
Yes.
Both. Both. When we went and saw the cops on Thursday morning, Luke and I, we said to them, they said, have you been in, do you know anything about the mistake bulldozer? And we said, yep, we'd heard that it had been vandalised. Have you been there recently? And we said, yep. I launched into a rave about how we wouldn't do that because we're all non-violent action trained and not into violence because it's shitting in our own nest. No, no, no. It's not difficult for me to accept. It's difficult for me to pass on to the others. I think the only way that you're going to get us out of there is by taking one of them to court. And I'd like to see you try that one, Steve. That's the only way that you're going to get us out of the forest. You close it, we'll disappear further into the forest. You won't see us, but we'll still be there. You won't see us because we're forest dwellers, and we know that forest like the back of our hand. That's going to be the consequence if you close the forest. You've got to come and drag one of us into court, kicking and screaming, and find out what happens. Don't you think we're responsible enough to live in a forest? Were they living in the forest in extreme fire danger conditions last year? Get out of the bloody forest! I'm sorry you don't understand, but get out of the bloody forest. Occupational Health and Safety Act, Bushfires Act, Forestry Act. He cannot guarantee our safety, and he cannot guarantee the safety of the forest. That's why he's got no choice but to remove us from the forest, and he will use any means possible to get us out of the forest. I said, the only way you're going to get us out of the forest, Steve, is to drag us, one of us kicking and screaming into court. What happens? We get fined, you get some money, we dart back to the forest like a rubber band, because it's where we live. Or you close the forest. We just go deeper into the forest. You can't find us. We're still there. You can't find us. It's even more of a worry. Just get off our backs, Steve. No, 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 I can't. I've got obligations that I can't get out of under the Occupational Health and Safety Act.
So when does he want people out?
Friday. Today week. Yes. Which is already a week over the period that when the bushfire danger period starts anyway. So you're getting a fortnight. You've been on notice for a long time that you have to get out of that forest.
So, I wonder when they want to start now. They put it back a few days because they have to alter the harvest plan significantly. So they want to start Monday week.
Significantly again, too.
Why so?
Well, I'm going to write a letter to Parks and Wildlife today demanding that they vary the license to include the
Kempsey Warhope prescriptions because they're the best there are at the moment. Through their court case, they may get some better prescriptions in place, but that's still a month away. We've got possible logging starting on Monday.
We've still got yellow-bellied gliders and koalas in the compartment they won't admit are there.
Oh, and
let alone Palmer wallabies.
Palmer wallabies and betongs and God knows what else. Oh, all this logging encourages new growth, and these little beasties,
they eat the
new growth and that, and things. Yeah, it's a crock of shit. I better get into town.
Yeah, what's the memorial about?
Three young kids that were missing from here in late 1990. Some were caught for, but he ended up getting off it.
Yeah, really?
Mm.
And so what, they disappeared?
Yeah, they just went missing one night at parties. The youngest one just went walking about one morning and never come back. They've done it in dedication to the three people. To the three young kids.
And so these are in the shapes of animals, yeah, the best?
Yeah, one in the shape of a turtle, sea turtle, and one in the shape of a snake.
Put a hard hat on and the greenies in the forest. Bit of a step up from Steve Mason's plastic hat. And this has got nature written all over it, not just a name. So there you go.
Mother, I feel you under my feet. Mother, I hear your heartbeat.
You were going down Mackay's Road.
What happened that day? We drove up to Mackay's Road. We decided, do we go down Mackay's Road or down the easy road? We decided to go down the hard road. Cruising down, five of us in the back at the time. And suddenly we stopped. There in front of us was a giant machine, like a semi-trailer with oversized. Moving across it.
Huge motherfucker truck.
Yeah, big truck.
Yeah.
And Jarrah leans out the driver's window and says, "Hey, what's going on here?" And they say, "Oh, well, we're going to log today."
He said, "For legal reasons, do not log."
Yes, and he says,
don't do a thing for legal reasons.
Legal
do
reasons.
Not. And then he turns the car around and he's going, oh, fucking yellow fucking glider, fucking rah, 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 rah. You can delete that if you like. And
no, don't.
And then,
it's more fun.
And then we charge back to camp, and Jared takes off in the car and races into camp and says, there's a bulldozer in the compartment. And everybody goes, yeah! People are screaming all over the place.
Before they left.
And everybody grabbed the drums, and then we raced off and grabbed a bit more gear, like ropes and stuff, and threw it all in the car and ran around in circles and jumped and yelled and raced back and pulled up. And when we got there,
we were
drumming and yahooing and wailing and whistling and going crazy and ready to lock on and everything. And then we cooled down a bit. We went and talked to them and they said, oh, blah, 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 we have to wait until our forestry man comes up. So a few of us went off to get tripod poles down the road. She climbed up the dozer.
We're asking the guys all these amazing questions like, you married, you got kids and...
Yeah, got a heart. That's what Esperanza was saying. Have you got a heart? Have
you
got a conscience? Can you feel anything? Esperanza, wasn't that beautiful, that conversation, that heart conversation you had with them, about half an hour of it or something?
So what are you going to do now? You're going to get off and get reinforcements?
Yeah, we got reinforcements. We got to go get reinforcements. Then we're going to go back and see if they've decided to come back tomorrow or not. If they've decided to come back tomorrow, then we'll just whack up tripods and stuff.
We've decided to blockade Little Wonder tonight with tripods and whatever else we can whack up there until a comprehensive independent survey has been done of the compartment, because this morning we found no more than 10 metres in front of the most recent bulldozer track a bunch of koala scats right on the track, 10 metres in front of where they were going to push the road to. They've found no yellow-bellied feed notches up there, although we've heard them for months and months and months going off in the compartment. They agree that independent checks should be done, but they don't like our independence. Our independent survey is apparently crap to them. So we're just going to blockade until we can get some kind of agreement from them.
And what, they just turned up with the dozers in there today?
Yeah, we accidentally turned down Mackay's Road instead of going down Horseshoe and found the dozer sitting in the compartment with forestries and loggers surrounding it. We haven't finished our yellow belly survey. We haven't finished the rainforest typing discrepancy check. We haven't done the check of the marking foreman's work. They haven't done an archaeological survey to the Gumbungi's satisfaction. So we figure that any agreement that we've previously signed is out the window until they can satisfy us that there are no yellow bellies in that compartment, and they're not going to do that because we've heard them. State Forest flatly refuse, and have done several times, to come up at night, although they're talking about it now. I heard Dale McLean saying that maybe they will spend the night up there looking at the, you know, spotlighting and stuff. Until that happens, we're gonna not allow them to work.
Oh, well, I guess I'll see you up there.
Yeah.
About 800 metres up there. Like, the security guys are down there, all the equipment's in the compartment. Yeah, we can't blockade from the top.
We're not going to be moving them out of there.
We can't set tripods up or lock onto the equipment.
So they're already in there, so what's the use? They got the diesel there, they can stay there for as long as they want.
That's right.
They can, those are just are there now.
Yeah, well, that top bit, we can still
if
keep
them. If we would have caught them here, on the corner here, we'd have been laughing.
Well, that was the plan all along.
But we didn't catch them here.
Well, the camp moved, eh?
Yeah. Well, once when the camp moved, well, they moved straight in, didn't they? Soon Steve fucking seen we was out of there. He most probably just give them the order to kill and went straight in, they did.
Yep.
They're there and we not moved them now.
It's a bit hard to move the camp back in there now.
Yep. A lot of hard to move the camp back in there.
They're parked right in the log dump where the teepees were.
Yep, two security guards.
Exactly where we thought that they were going to start logging from, and they started from there, where we had the bloody old camp.
Oh, well, let's hope everybody gets back tonight after their meeting then.
Yeah, well.
We need a lot of people, you know.
A bit more support right there, eh?
Yeah.
It's right to get all these contractors and that and see what they got to say tomorrow. All these loggers.
Well,
the poor bastards who just cut the timber. They're the fellas we're going to have a yarn to. Tell them to go to hell. You're doing illegal acts. An Aboriginal land, or soon to be, hopefully.
That's right.
The claim is already in. Yeah. They can't say that it isn't.
That's right.
And they're supposed to stop everything until that fucking tribunal decides on who owns what and where and when.
Yeah,
it's supposed to be law to us, law, ain't it? Back in the system, that's how it's supposed to work.
That's how it's supposed to work. You're equal owners with forestry until the tribunal decides.
Everyone's out trying to save koalas and that, and these bastards are up here fucking dozering away their habitat trees. Nothing left of the yellow-bellied gliders. Look, they're just surviving here.
Yeah. Right underneath.
Yep.
The noses of everyone who's been looking
for. Pushing the dozers straight through their fucking heartland now. The only places left they do survive. You can't go any further west. What's out there?
Fucking bear paddocks.
Bear paddocks and sheep and fucking shit like that. Rabbits everywhere.
Dead trees.
And boulders.
Dead tree forests.
Yep. Fucking sticks. Can't push them any further. Gotta stop somewhere. It might as well be here. We might as well stop them here than fucking end of the range where there's gonna be nothing left by then. Might as well be here.
Hey brother.
How you doing?
Good.
Fuck you. Boss, name's Will.
Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me.
He's going to try and blockade the forestry workers in the end.
Yeah, and we we don't have any choice because the dozers are in there and there's fucking two security guards there with guns. So it's not exactly appropriate to blockade to put tripods over the bloody machines. Which is a real shame because they're right close to each other. We probably could have gotten both with one pot. Hey.
Yeah.
And the diesel tanker.
Maybe we should go and shoot fucking.
What we're gonna do is wake up in the morning to occupy the tripods and this is the plan.
Plus we've got plenty of gear as well. Plenty of gear to lock on with.
Great stuff.
Yeah.
See you soon.
Do it a little bit tighter.
So you get the tall people. Tall people on the vehicle.
It's just the vehicle.
Plane.
Lights out.
It's a plane.
Yeah, it's a plane.
Now this one's underneath. This is a push pole. There's the underneath and the over the top. Fucking school, and we're going to the underneath school tonight.
Yeah.
Tensions. As soon as it starts going up, the tensions, and it becomes a tension knot.
Hmm. Okay. I've seen this operation before.
Can someone put the lid on that can so this?
How many got that in?
Well, we need more people down here. This is torch down. Super light.
See what's happening here. Tightening up too much?
No.
Get up there, you carry a piece of rope up with you, tie it round the opposite way. Tie it round that way rather than that way.
Yeah.
Just do a tie around that way. And you tie it up. Set. Then you take up an extra bit of rope to hang down. A hang down rope.
Yeah.
But people are going to send you up stuff. You need to support that.
Get up there, yeah! Feel secure, right!
Little wonder free state, man! Okay. Yeah, voice prediction, I get excited.
There's like a break there. Are we out of rope? Are we kind of got you climbing right now?
No, we've still got plenty of rope.
Do you want to go another one?
Little tripod.
I love it. Occupy tripod.
Hands up the people who have jobs here.
Here?
This right side. Here. This side.
This place.
Dan's up the pod. Lou's supporting these two. Nadia's out the thing. Who's that there? Ren's up the pod with Dan. Will's up the pod. Andrew's up the pod.
And Will you're gonna trash rock on. The road, right?
He no. says, yeah.
Oh, there's none
so
left.
That's a crew.
We need to have,
so, who's no, left? And again, who's not got a job up here now? Hands up high so I can see.
Andrew, you've got a job.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. We got ourselves a tripod crew. And six, I nine. Guess...
You get the coffees first.
Have we you got get a, three...
Have you got a volunteer to go up, mate? Basically.
Yeah, out of that group, who wants to go up?
It's quite well, it's possible opposite. You won't be arrested, guys, so...
The main action's likely to be up here.
Up here. So it's going to be a pretty easy
And the cops run, can't be in two places at once.
I think it was 20 metres here as well, around the rainforest and 100 metres from the creek. And then they gave the river users group 350 metres from the creek, but that was because it was all over 30 degrees.
Oh. Over 30?
Yeah.
Well, it's recommended not over 35. It's not recommended not over 25, but they can go up to 30.
Yeah.
Or more.
It probably worked out that 25 would cut out too much and made a little way.
This would be the first way they'd come in for sure. But do you reckon they don't even know?
They think this is all this. They don't know that those stuff like that's been locked on and they don't know. They're quite in shock. They don't know the other ones from it. Well, they think this is it.
And they don't know about the bottom of the road or anything.
I don't know. Walking in this one.
Security guards up in the compartment, they got radios?
Yeah, they got a mobile. They came down, both of them came down, while our crew was going back up, and they've apparently captured them.
Well, I better go up there then.
Probably.
Well, thanks. Hope you don't mind me filming in the daytime.
Nah, mate. Better than night time, innit?
You've got a shot.
You only would have got the back of the buddy greater, wouldn't you, last night?
Yeah, that's about it. So what's happened to you then?
Don't know. This poor girl managed to get a chain wrapped around her neck and just attach this daisy. That's amazing.
It's amazing things happen, isn't it?
Yeah. How's that? It's about jewelry display.
Latest jewelry.
Latest in long fashion.
Is that in the...
Right, they were here, and the others weren't here, and they were just like, just the two people were here, and I just walked up and talked to them, and then this young brother turned up, and I had a rave to them, and then they ended up saying, oh, we're blocked in, and, you know, we'll go and check it out, and they all just got up and got in the car, and I said, oh, are you leaving me here? And they just said, yes, we'll give you $10 an hour for minding the bulldozers, and I said, oh, okay. See you later. And they got in the car and left. And Ingrid and Amanda came running on the scene. And that was it. It was really, they left and left them to us.
All of this?
All of
this.
You. And said we could, I could mine them and they'd pay me for it.
Oh, you didn't do the job.
I didn't do the job very well for them though.
Oh, you could put it down at the CES though.
I could, couldn't I? Yeah.
They offered me a job.
But I failed the test.
I'll let the greens lock on.
Are they good places? Do you lock them on in good places?
How are you feeling?
Good, yeah.
Quite
well, these ones good ones, are you? Like, we're just trying to get the best comfortable ones. Yeah. Killer place, isn't it?
Look, it's a great place. It's quite cozy.
How do they get the cryptos off?
Some sort of cutters, I guess.
Yeah. Very shortly. Right, and all of the forestry vehicles are up the top road, so the people down the bottom are probably coming back any minute.
Okay, excellent. Sure. And they can't get through the tripods at all.
No, but there's not enough people down there, so I've got to get back there in just a minute.
Yeah, cool.
Comfortable?
Yeah, really comfortable. Yeah, good sleep here.
Good. Might have to at this rate.
So you guys do this, are you professional greenies?
No, or? I live down the hill actually, I'm just here to video it.
Right.
A couple of the others here, oh, they travel around a bit, but most of the people here, they've actually been in the forest for about a year.
Yeah.
Camped up around here. Mm. So not so much professional greenies, as I guess professional squatters right now.
Yeah, that's one. That's one.
But a bit of both, yeah.
Well, it's about time if I can, that's why people start getting a bit of land back.
They've gone down to dismantle a dozer.
Oh dear, is something wrong with it?
Morning, how's it going?
Ah, oh, good, good.
Well, try going the other way, but it won't get in. I've got a tripod like that, look, there's a gate there, right? A tripod like that, and another one like that, over the same gate. There's only five of them down there, but the springs are right onto it.
Ha ha! Are
you okay? Hey, okay, fine.
Great.
I'm happy. And
Roger, Roger.
Roger, Dodger.
I don't know what the next move is.
More overly, and then they're less sure of what they should do. It makes it just a little bit more dynamic. Go up, make it clear, be the ones in charge, this is what we're doing, this is our limit.
Let's tell Steve that when he gets here. Let's get him up here. Waste his time, waste his money, waste Forrester's money.
What if he just gives instructions over the radio? Like there's 11 people there and two security guards waiting for instructions from Steve Racing. And he's deciding what instruction to give without knowing what your ultimatum is.
Just tell me exactly what you want done, and then they'll start full rolling. There you go, that's what we want.
And then, well, that's what we're told. Give us this, we'll leave you alone. I'll talk to you as a group.
Okay.
Okay.
Situation is, right, I've spoken to my superiors at Port Macquarie and at Maxwell. At this stage, the harvest plan is a legal document which gives the loggers the right to go in and start their operations. At this stage, the Forest Commission are prepared to let you stay in the area and negotiate, but if there's any obstruction to their operations, the forest will be closed and you'll be asked to leave the area.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, are you prepared to let the blokes go in to start their operations?
We're prepared to let these guys go in and start work once we've been satisfied that State Forests have done what they said they were going to do.
At this stage, the options that are open to you, if you feel that the harvest plan is not correct or whatever, is that I've been advised that you should take out legal proceedings again and take out an injunction or whatever. But at this stage, you're hampering a lawful operation. And
it's not lawful until we've seen a final harvesting plan.
That's
that
fair
we're
enough.
Happy with.
Right, but
that was the agreement that we reached.
Right, okay. Now, I'm officially directing you to move the roadblock. If you fail to remove the roadblock and let the police, let the loggers commence their operations, you will be either arrested or legal action will be taken against you. Do you understand that?
Me personally?
Well, everybody that...
We have half an hour to talk about it as a group.
Righto. But that's all I can give you. Right, I've got to be fair to both sides.
Yeah.
At this stage, the Forestry Commission, like I said, are prepared to let you stay in your camp down there if you don't hamper their operations. But
we agreed.
Mate, that's what it is. I'm not.
No, no, no. Just let me finish. We agreed. We, the forest dwellers, agreed to not hinder logging operations. We signed the agreement on the condition that State Forests do several things. We're not happy with those several things. We don't believe that they've been done to our satisfaction. And until they are done to our satisfaction, we will hinder logging operations.
Well, that's what I've been directed, or I've been authorised, or I've been instructed to do. That's
Would you like to communicate what I've just told you to your superiors?
Before you do that, let's have half an hour and work out our message.
That's all you've got, mate. Because these blokes are ready to start work. At this stage, they're lawfully entitled to start work. The harvest plan has been approved.
Yep.
Okay. If you've got any objections to it, there's ways and means that you can do it lawfully. Okay. But at the moment, this is an unlawful roadblock and you are committing an offence. Okay.
Right, I understand that, but honestly, they have been trying to do everything lawfully. I really have.
I know. That's fair enough. But that's just the way it is, okay?
Okay.
Righty-o.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, call me. Well,
you know.
An illegal roadblock.
Well, is this illegal? Stuck up here doing an illegal activity.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
You can pull out now if you want.
Oh.
And take legal means.
Call me beforehand. Look, I'm going to sue somebody.
Sue.
I've just got to rig it up.
We could fuck them up. We could go. A couple of people still going home now. We'll back up there and we'll go down the road.
And what?
Put up another pod in front of the cage. You know, if you want to string it out. So it's going to go into night. So night, please. Then another day.
Well, they're talking about closing the forest over 600 cubic meters.
Okay,
the prison.
Yeah, they
can do it. Yeah. And crap. Where's,
what, just
this
compartment? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's all
I want.
Do you think they've been down to the other place and told them the same thing?
No. I don't know.
No, they don't know that they're there. And we really need them.
I think we get on the blower right now, get the radio up, that's the priority. Get the radio up and firing and get as many of them down there up here as possible. Tell them the cops are in and they won't close us down. And that, you know, they're already up here. They're not digging up
Random
here
mate.
At all. They can basically abandon that pod to two people, virtually.
Yeah, just man it. They'll wait and get a fucking cherry picker up here. There's probably one on its bloody way.
George is right there, they've got a pile of people here, they could do it any one of a number of ways. We better get a pile of people here fast, one way or the other.
Is that ready to go?
We've only got half an hour, they're going to come back for an answer. Are you going to say that we're staying and that we'd like to speak to Steve Raisin today? We'd really like to be working this out with Steve Raisin.
Say today, right? But, you know, like, and everybody can appreciate your views, and we're not here to take sides. We don't want a confrontation, but the log is, you know, like, as you can appreciate, it's cost them a lot of money to set up and all that sort of thing too, and they've got sort of rights as well, but like I said, the forestry, they're prepared to negotiate and let you stay in the forest as long as the operations aren't hampered. But if they are hampered, well then, you know, like, action's going to have to be taken.
I understand, but you've got to understand too that the situation with forestry is, we actually have got an agreement on with forestry, and part of the agreement is that before they come in and log, that we're allowed to inspect the tree markings, we're allowed to inspect, this is all in black and white with forestry, that's what we don't understand. They haven't met their legal obligations under a legally binding document, and that's why we're here. So it's the same from both sides, you see.
Fair enough.
You're in the middle, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know, I'm in the middle, I can appreciate that, but that's just what the go is at this stage, right, from the police point of view. The harvest plan is a lawful document, and you know, like, if you, from this is from our point of view, if you want to take action against it, you should do it through the courts. That's our advice, and like, and what you do from here on is up to you. Okay.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
If we decide to stay here until we can negotiate with Steve Raisin, will you be bringing in police from Nambucca or?
Yeah, police are coming, right?
They're already called. How many police are coming?
I don't know, but there are other police coming, but at this stage, it's not for a confrontation, it's for negotiations.
Right.
So that's why, you know, like, and that's the,
Is there any way we can contact Steve Raisin and get him to come out today and go for a walk with the people here before the logging's begun, so they can walk around and finalise the hosting? Spend the day doing
we're also waiting
like that,
for
working with everybody to get it done.
There's an independent person coming to check out the disputed yellow belly colony. So that's sort of basically what we're waiting for him to turn up. He said hopefully today, but it's not definite. So.
Alright.
So we really want to avoid this as well, but that's sort of our priority. We want to avoid this confrontation, but we do also, you know, there's people here who feel really strongly that they have actually had their agreement breached and might not be so easy to move. So what we want is more time to maybe try and work out a middle ground with Steve before anything does happen. And that might take us more than half an hour. It'd be good to actually be speaking to him maybe on a mobile phone.
That's a matter for the Forestry Commission. I'll see if I can find out if he is coming.
So it's basically a lack of communication at this stage, and we've got to communicate with them to work it out before this can be solved. So we'd like time to do that.
Well, at this stage, that's all I've been, you know, asked to convey to you, is that, you know, like, if you're going to have a talk, try to do it. Like, I don't think you're going to have all day to be able to try to talk it out. I'll go see Steve Raisin.
Can
come.
We get the
unit
on the phone or anything.
One of the main reasons this went up was that we were so pissed off that they started without telling us. And without doing a full YVG check, they said that they'd be coming up in a couple of days. They also said that they'd do the rainforest typing discrepancies business. They also said that they'd do the check that the marking formers work. But they're in here starting to cut before we've had a chance to do it.
I can't comment on their policy.
Well, yeah, I'm just communicating to you why we've got this here.
Yeah.
We'd like to be able to come to a final harvesting plan. I mean, God, they're down to 600 cubic metres. These guys are small sawmillers. We're not against them. They're taking all the timber to their mill. It's not going to boil, so there's no jack-up about wood chips. As far as we know, had it been 4,000, we would have been here because of the wood chips, and we wouldn't have let anybody through until they, you know, sacked Boral or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Mate, yeah, that's what something you've got to negotiate out, fair enough, and all I can convey to you is that's the situation at this stage.
What's going with the other joint, man?
The owls.
Trust me, to you, it doesn't
matter.
No worries.
To Steve, probably not really change the land when we've spoken to him.
Always wanted to see a advice line.
You never see one like this?
He gave it away, you know. It's going to be, you know, it's a bluff.
It's a bluff, that's right.
It's good. It's simple. You know, you haven't got it on, can't get your pay, but it's a fucking bluff.
Yeah. And there's cops on the way. Which means that there'll be a cherry picker on the way as well.
What do they reckon on the radio, though?
I'll just do that,
Brenna. She didn't know if anybody specifically was on their way up, but she was going to do the ring around and find out if anybody could come up. I'll go and talk to her again in 10, 15 minutes.
Fucking didn't give a shit, you know? Fuck this! Fucking knew the bulldozer started up. It was going.
Well, he started the engine.
Yeah, I thought he was about to take off. And then Zach ran in front and he shoved Zach off. And he's out for the person who's got the keys. Like, they're fucking dead meat. And I'm just going, fuck you, you know? Fucking fully going off, hey. And we're going, oh, cool. And we said, okay,
it's
like, we're trying to work out, okay, what are we going to do, you know? The guys on the border are probably safe now, but now they're off the back of the keys.
Yeah. And I've come to track down to find it. We also heard the police aren't coming up.
Yeah, they're over
here. They've already been here.
And it's gone.
No, we've been discussing what we should do. Fuck, oh, they were telling us the police weren't coming, that was it. See you later.
Lots of police on the way, though.
Yeah. Yeah, oh, that's cool then. I'll go and tell it's back on then.
Yeah.
Oh, cool, okay.
Definitely off.
Yeah, maybe not for a little while.
If you feel
though.
Unsafe, back then.
Yeah, it's
don't.
Pretty. Oh, the security guards are cool. Like, they're about to pull out their guns on the. What's his name?
The
security guards down here.
They're real rednecks, hey? Like, they're full
come
on.
Come on in!
Like, they were just like. When it comes to life, it's like, it was full on, mate. Like, he was going, I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. We're going, she's going to die, you know. He's going, I don't give a fuck, you know.
Yeah, he was saying that this morning walking that pole.
Yeah, but he had it started and he was starting to move it a bit round.
And he grip was underneath it.
Yeah.
And the security guards pulled their guns on him.
He was just lifting up the blade and putting it down and, you know, just
did they pull it? Did they pull
totally.
Their guns out?
Oh, you grip.
You're going, we know where your fucking camp is. We can come in and bash you up any time we want to. And, like, they're going to be up for Zach's blood. They've got him on target.
Come on, Zach, get out of there, man.
Yeah.
He was just hanging with you because you guys apparently said you weren't going to touch it.
Well, that's bullshit, you know.
That's what he said.
You touched it. You touched my machine.
Touched. That's right.
As opposed to wreck.
I said.
Yeah, well, that's what Glenn was going off with him, you know. He's saying, look, you know, that's the point, you know. Like, we're not wrecking your machines. We're touching them. We're not wrecking them. And they just went off about half an hour on that tangent, you know.
Does anybody have any dressings for wounds?
Yeah, I need some too. The girls was locked on and he just got straight into his bulldozer and started up, and it was only that someone else ran out in front of him and jumped in front of him and he ended up assaulting that person and throwing him aside, that and everyone else, including the
security officers were saying, look, stop, you're going to kill her. And he was like, I don't give a fuck. She can go. And he was full on, like he was going to do it. What else happened then? Yeah, like it's, he was, you know, and he's put death threats on everyone after the camp. He's saying he's going to go in there and bash the fuck out of everyone and kill them all. He doesn't care.
Oh, yeah. I'll speak to him. But what the offer is at this stage, well, I'll just go for once again.
Is everybody listening?
Right, but what they want to do this morning is get work started on the log dump, which is down over the side where there is no colonies.
Where the full trees are down over the side where they were late yesterday afternoon.
Right.
Okay, so you're agreeing not to log the area where it was said that we believe there are yellow-bellied gliders.
That's
from, is that right?
That's from
use the ramp site in that area where they pulled those two logs up there yesterday where the tractor is and the grader is.
Now.
Use that ramp site.
What about the old snake track?
I don't believe it.
What about the old snick track? Do you want to push that old snick track through today?
I don't know which... The snick track just passed log dump too.
I don't know...
You know where they went down yesterday?
Yeah.
That's the snigging track they want to use.
Well, there's a problem there. We've just found 60 koala scats in front of the bulldozer. Is it?
Yeah.
And they're
I'm sorry, I don't think...
They're not going down that one at the moment because of the koala scats.
Uh-huh.
It's been
good. So... Ren, I don't know where everything is in there. Does it sound to you like they're going to avoid the area where there's yellow bellies?
I just want to have someone independent, you know, some mediator in between that can, you know, may have more open eyes, may see, you know, if they have a love for fauna, may see what they want to see rather than dollar signs on trees. Because what we have
to
decide...
You know where we went yesterday? Is that in dispute? Where we went yesterday afternoon, you know, where the dozer started off and went down, they pulled the two logs up. Is that in dispute there?
There's a dispute about the whole compartment because, I mean, we found those scats, you know, 20 metres, and they're on a track, and they hadn't been spotted by any forestry people, so that just says that they haven't done proper surveys on the whole compartment, you know?
Righto. Where they want to commence this morning and get underway is down over the side where... They believe from no yellow belly in that area, and the only disturbance to the top end will be is stinging the logs up to the ramp and the loading of the logs at the ramp site. But there will be no trees felled in that area, and that's the offer, right? He's more or less conveyed. Well, if you're not prepared to negotiate and make a concession there, well, there's no more deals.
We have some time to think about it, and Jarrah's gone down to Steve Rayson now, right, and speak to him about it, so we need time to confer, and, you know.
That's the offer he asked me to make, fair enough, right?
Yeah. Okay, we'll get to you.
Thanks very much. But the girls up there are a bit worried as well.
Police up there, because it's quite scary for the people up there.
Well, there's only one of me at this stage.
Can no one else down there go up there, because that's what's scaring them,
because
those people are scaring them, they're really threatening
people, like death threats. Well, wouldn't it be better, like, I can't be here and back down there, like, stretch it at this stage, wouldn't it be better, like, the tripods are here, right, I'm not going to sneak in and attack at this stage or do anything, you know, silly, righto, there's only one of me, righto, just bring the girls back down here and you stay together here as a group.
We can't
unlock them. That's the serious fact.
And that's what we were trying to tell him when he just kept on trying to start the engine.
What's his dozer, yeah, and
you don't have a key, and there's a person's life at risk, actually. Very close friend of mine.
I understand, I wasn't there, I haven't been past this point, but all I will say, as I understand it, they went up, the man that went with them was a service man, they fitted a new oil gauge, they had to test the oil pressure in the new oil gauge, it was only an oil gauge, they started the engine and lifted the blade. And, wait there, just hold it. I'm only saying what... the engine, he lifted the blade, this blade's lifted with oil pressure, he's lifted the blade, he had to rev the motor, and that's what he did. Now, I wasn't there...
What was he doing up when somebody underneath a dozer?
Right.
It's his dozer.
Later?
Well, it's cost them a fortune to bring up a...
There's a person under there. Money is completely out of the question. There is a person underneath that dozer.
Right, it's his dozer. They've
paid big money to get a service maintenance man. I heard, but you're not listening either. Yeah. Well, I'm not going to get into arguments, right? But you can't have it all one way.
No.
Okay? So, yeah, it's got to go both ways. I'm not going to. I don't want to get into any arguments or discussions.
And here's some more people whose water catchment we're talking about.
So let's walk.
Okay. Well, maybe I should have brought my car.
Great to see you.
Yeah, it's good to see you.
Some people from downstream.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Will.
I'm Georgia.
Hello.
Well,
we're mainly talking about animals' lives up here. Right? You've got the quality of water.
Yeah, sure. It's all part of the bigger picture. If there's no trees, there's no animals. If there's no trees, there's no water. It's all part.
Do you agree at all to any native logging?
No. Of course, no, no.
Maybe you shouldn't have anything with negotiations because they're going to. I mean, it's a regrowth section and they are under the harvesting plan. I would love it. You've already got an incredible harvesting plan, Jay. I don't know what the fuck you people are complaining about. Just give them the fauna sites and go fucking home.
Yeah, let's stop upsetting people.
Don't come at me like that.
You just walked in here and you started accusing
people. I'm not fucking accusing anybody. Look, last time.
Stop fucking yelling.
Don't make any agreements with them. That's all I'm saying.
I won't even talk.
Please.
Did anyone in Buckaroo make an effort to find out?
Nobody in Buckaroo was told. Nobody. We knew nothing about it.
Did you know that it was on the
I'm just going to go tell them that we'll just put them on hold.
I've written a letter to them. I've had no reply to that letter. In the letter it says that we believe that their marking foreman is incompetent as a wildlife surveyor. We want the Kempsey Warhope prescriptions and we want Parks and Wildlife and Forestry to come up here and do a
Where
survey.
Where is the dozers and stuff now?
There's two girls
chained to them.
They will throw us out of here, they will pull these down, they're bringing police up from Kempsey, they'll arrest us all, man, and then we stand to lose everything, right? We stand to lose all that we've got, right?
Well, no, that's not true. That's the bluff. You don't stand to lose anything. The harvest plan is a legal document.
It might be a bluff, Ram, but it's also a risk that we're facing, right? People are going to get arrested, man. Everyone's been here for 28 hours, we're all fucking buggered.
Yeah.
I don't think personally that there's a great many people that are
involved. I apologise, I had no right to come in. They want an answer now, do they? Is that
well,
the story?
They're getting itchy feet.
Well, they came up here this morning, right, with the police, and they gave us half an hour to come up with a decision, right?
Yeah.
Pending that the cops would come in, take this down, arrest us, and close the forest.
But that was a couple of hours ago now.
And they had it turned up.
There was one police sitting out there on
That's
the road.
That's the only policeman we've spoken with all day, mate.
He fucking pulled over his...
He said there's more police coming from Port Macquarie.
Right.
That's what he said, but they haven't turned up.
I mean, they'll tell you anything, though. I mean, you just got to...
Oh, of course. So.
Well, if they can talk you out, that's the best way to do it. I'd do the same.
That's it.
So, I don't well, why wouldn't you?
Yeah, it would be a classic case to run with them. Who? Parks and Wildlife issued the Forestry Commission with a licence to take and kill endangered species.
And also to pollute water.
Yeah. Who does the taking and killing and polluting?
The contract
doesn't
it?
Contract. It's not a subcontract. I've just been through a court case which the judge almost proved that we were acting lawfully by being up there and locked on because the other guy wasn't because he didn't have a license. Now that court case is still pending. It's gone to the Court
of Criminal
Appeal.
The individual contractor doesn't have a license.
If the contractor,
the forestry
have a license
to kill
but the
species.
Contractor needs it. The contractor needs the license, not the forestry.
Right, because he's the one doing the stuff.
He's the one
killing
taking,
the
disturbing, killing, trapping, snaring, whatever. Right.
There's an important piece of news here that affects everyone slightly.
I've just been talking. The forest is now closed. Okay, the police being this compartment, so as soon as you jump on that side of the road, you're not in the prohibited zone.
Everyone on
not
the counter
label. Prohibited side.
Hang on,
so
that
that's
means...
You're not allowed that side.
Yeah. We're just fighting road behind us.
Does that mean anyone else coming in can't come in?
They've gone to the front of the road to try to stop people. They cannot stop them forcibly. If they want to go through, they will go through and they cannot stop them forcibly. But people that will go up there and they'll say, well, the forest is closed, they may turn around without any of us being down there to say, it's not really, you can come in, but quickly.
Yeah, there might be other people, we're going to go on a barrow, we'll pick up more people.
Can I suggest just you hang here till just after 12?
Okay.
Because that's when your shit's going to be.
Well, if we saw anyone on the way, we were going to turn around and come straight back. If we saw the police coming up or anything, we were just going to turn around and come straight back.
Well, the police are on their way.
They are.
They've closed the forest. They're wiring it up for a restricted zone, so that's pinches off. Anybody that's not up a pipe at all locked on may possibly just get arrested after being told this is a little bit of zone and the police leave. And if you don't leave, they may grab you, which is clearly their right. I don't know whether Steve Ayson wants to negotiate at all. He's coming up.
Sure he doesn't.
He's offered to a certain thing. He's still going by that.
Look, this is the latest work, right? They're coming up, and you can just kind of sit and wait, and you can negotiate when he gets there. You'll be warned that the police may just close the forest instantly. At the moment, the forest is closed, then the police aren't here saying, you are in the restricted zone, because they're the only ones that can do that.
Yeah. So, who said they were coming? The police?
The forester, like, didn't talk to the police there. No, they won't forget, like, this is going to be weird, mate.
Who's up this pod? Who's going up this pod?
Who is that?
Who's this?
Yeah, it seems pretty volatile.
Cops wanted you up here.
They are a bit concerned about the situation. They thought if the this tree thing could be resolved, then it might quieten down a bit.
V-notches
between just here and the kilometre and a half down the road place where we were camped. There's also been koala scats found down the bottom there. I've just heard from Parks and Wildlife that they were informed by forestry yesterday, and Parks and Wildlife have allowed them to open an old road to get down into the bottom of the compartment. They're not allowed to go anywhere near where the koala scats were found or down in that yellow belly area. But we need
down
you...
The bottom,
so they're allowed in back into that bottom compartment.
That's under
one of their temporary licences.
Yeah.
One of the temporary licences.
Yeah.
The area that we know that the yellow bellies are in, according to them, didn't have V-notches because it was pretty lush vegetation and they could get food from other sources and they wouldn't necessarily need to do V-notches there, so that was how they sort of got out of it.
Which brings up a big question. If you've got V-notches, why do they have all these hell prescriptions? But if we've got recordings of the noises, why aren't the prescriptions valid? That's one of the burning issues here with this yellow belly stuff.
Right. So the simple lack of nocturnal surveys for arboreal mammals and coming up in the day in winter on blowy days,
looking for nocturnal animals during the day, isn't that great? Yeah, it makes heaps of sense. You work for the government. Yeah, you work from 9 to 5.
Well, from my experience with them, sometimes they're quite obvious that they're V-notches, and other times they're obvious that they're not.
Yeah.
And then there's an area of grey in between where you're not sure.
Yeah,
so.
I got a couple of yellow bellies on video actually just up here as well, so I'll just show you the trees they were sitting in.
Well, what's the problem with if you've got all these positive IDs of yellow bellies?
We went in with them. I didn't go in with them, but a few people went in yesterday with them, and they've been in before. Basically haven't found anything in the areas that we're looking.
So they're denying their existence?
They said that because it was a lush sort of forest, they probably wouldn't need to do V-notches, but they wouldn't be surprised at all if there were yellow bellies in that area because it was a highly likely place for them to live, but they might not necessarily do V-notches. But this is where I found them. They're two girls anyway, just here.
And they went off to Barbara?
Yeah.
So we'll put you on the line here. There's quite a few little marks on it, but you can sort of see when you get up there too. But on that big bulge there.
Yeah, right.
But yeah, it was under these black butts.
There's plenty of hollows around.
Yeah.
This is where we found some shoe balls as well when we came looking.
It's above the second branch to the left.
And there's somebody else with a nice little home over here as well.
Someone under that one too.
Okay. A body under there. They've run someone over.
But it is a great sleeping platform, eh?
I don't know. I don't think I'd want to sleep on it all night.
So this is Gabe's shack, eh? What sort of volume do you play it at?
As loud as you can, really. So, but I've just heard from somebody else who reckons he gets just as good a result playing it at a more normal thing. So it's a lot of those sort of things are suck at and see. But I've generally, in the surveys I've been on with National Park, we're generally playing through a megaphone, I think. Playing as loud as they can go again, yeah, you're just still. Right. And what I think about it, packs it off to Sue Walker, recommending that there be more para surveys done in the area and that they revise the prescriptions. See what, see what she does with it, but I click on the page and get off the day for it.
Fantastic.
Certainly suitable habitat. Suitable habitat for a number of endangered species. G'day. Well, I might make a move.
Well, look, thanks very much for your time. Yeah, right.
See you later.
And drop in any time, please.
Bye. Everybody's got a bloody video today.
You should get some women placement up there too, eh?
Yeah.
You
authorisation. I'm not moving until I've seen a piece of paper that has a boundary on it and that has state forests say that this area is now prohibited. I know that I'm well within my rights to say that. I need to see a piece of paper which says this forest is now closed with some boundaries. No, 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 it's got to be written out tight.
Yeah, it is tight.
Tight piece of paper.
This is my piece of paper. And it's got the boundaries marked with the area that is closed. And you people, this is closed.
What's the story with national parks? Are they coming up tonight? We heard rumours that they were.
I have no idea what national parks are doing at this stage.
Right.
All I'm doing is suggesting you put the places closed. We're asking you to leave, hopefully, at your own will.
Yeah, yeah.
Around 11 a.m.
Otherwise, police action will
happen. Yeah, yeah.
Is it agreed that you won't go into the area that's still being disputed about the yellow bellies and the koala scats? Because we've just had the expert here, and he's highly recommending that national parks come out here and do a nocturnal study. Highly recommending.
There's no further discussion.
They're prohibited where we live.
That's wonderful.
They're prohibited where we live.
Down this road.
You know what? This is two issues here, and one of them,
prohibited where we live.
And we've watched what happened to our rivers. Okay, why don't the people listen? I mean, how come we have to get all our levels to get any
action?
Yet you can do anything you bloody like.
That's not.
Not you, but the loggers.
Right. So, unfortunately, at this stage, the forest has been closed, and we've got to ask you to move on.
Good on you. Good on you, State Forest. You never want to see.
Hey, I saw the look on your face when you saw that greater start yesterday.
What a mob of wankers. I don't want to let anybody see what they're doing. So they've got to close
fast hectares of forest.
600 cubic metres they want to take out of here.
But
so they've got to close. Okay. How big is it? How big is it? That's.
That's humongous.
Cabbage Tree Creek, Kosakai Road, McKay's Road, the bottom of Little Wonder Creek. Oh man, that's like thousands of hectares.
That's my backyard.
Thousands of hectares. They want to lock 600 cubic meters. Bullshit,
they want to
lock 600 cubic
metres. You and other residents are allowed to walk in their backyard virtually.
I canoe up and down with my kids up and down that river. I haven't swum in it for 3 fucking years. And for you people logging it, some jerk out there that doesn't have any trees on the property and who gets landslides that go into it. I know what you can do. You can grow polonia trees that take 8 years to grow and you won't do it.
They're only going to lock that compartment, but they've prohibited several thousand hectares. Jeez, I'd like to have a job in State Forest so I had the power to throw people out of where they live. Plants, animals, humans. Fuck, I'd like to have a job with State Forest.
Everybody's access to everywhere.
There's a lot of locals living here as well. You've got people here whose backyards are prohibited from.
My backyard's prohibited from me. There's my backyard just there.
So you're not allowed to walk over your back ridge virtually. No. Nobody's allowed to go out of their property. No one's allowed to use the forest.
Nobody.
It's a $2,000 fine if you set foot over the edge.
Yep. You have a look.
That's what it says.
You have a look.
That's what it says.
If you're a warning, they say you're in a river zone. If you don't leave, you'll be.
Yeah.
We've been given a warning.
But virtually.
We've been given the warning, right? That's the warning. Right. I now have nowhere to live.
Irrespective of this week's worth of logging, any more he will talk to us on, you're saying?
Yeah, he said he'll come back and engage me.
Chris, you're not allowed to go over the backyard into the forest.
Hang in.
You're not allowed to go over the your backyard into the forest. They closed the forest. It's a $2,000 fine on you walking over your back boundary.
Without hacking a hell of a lot of trees down.
Get it up here, mate.
Hey?
I don't think you feel like getting arrested, Jared. It's my decision.
Yeah.
What we'll do, right, you've been given the direction.
How long have we got?
Listen to me.
Hang on, let him go.
The direction is valid from this point onwards. We'll go back down there and give you a chance to talk amongst yourselves in peace.
What about our camp?
Mate,
what about our camp?
You're going to have to move.
Where to?
I don't know.
How?
I don't know.
How long have we got?
We'll be reasonable about it, but you're going to have to move.
How long have we got?
Well, as soon
as
possible.
Tomorrow?
No.
Well, when can we come back?
When you say reasonable.
Whose discretion is that up to? To the loggers?
Yeah. We're not allowed off of our... You mean we're not allowed... I own 120 acres over here. I'm not allowed over my back boundary there.
No,
I'm not allowed over.
Technically, no.
I don't agree with that. I'm sorry, but I don't agree with it.
It's common sense.
I understand that.
If you've got to go for whatever, do something that you normally do of a day or whatever, that's not the booth.
What about living? Yeah, what about living?
The booth is, like I said, that. For control purposes, yeah. That whole area is being closed.
Yeah.
So if you do...
You even care? Until
when?
Until the forestry commissioner
who's calling all the shots and you do what they tell you to do,
Can we get the forestry plan from the forest? I mean, they don't even live here.
Can we?
Right, we're going to go, like I said, I'm not going to argue.
Okay.
I've given you a direction.
Steve Rayson's
the one to ask these questions.
He's up the hill. He's up the hill in there now.
He said he'll come back and
discuss it.
The policeman said to us he will come back and tell us... And he'll discuss it with us.
Right, but I'm giving a direction. The direction is from this point onwards,
2 o'clock,
we'll give you time to have a talk amongst yourselves to decide what you want to do, but then we're going to have to forcibly remove anybody that is still here.
Shouldn't there be a consultation with Steve Rayson before this happens?
Nah.
Why not? Between...
I've just given them the demand, that's the forestry, it. I don't want to get into any arguments.
The forestry have told the police what to do. The police are doing what they're told by the forestry.
No, the forestry is virtually their
boss.
So the
forestry is the boss of all of this, not the police, not anybody. The forestry do what they're told by the government. And we voted them in. Well, not me personally, but...
Not me.
Not me.
I particularly don't feel like getting arrested right now. I mean, I don't know what marks.
In fact,
I think...
Steve Rayson. Like, you know, well, what are they going to do? They're going to get us down and...
Well, it'll take...
They'll arrest you and then tow the cars. That's what they said. They'll arrest you and the cars will be towed.
They're not going to be able to get them out for a time.
We can have that, Jared, can't we?
What?
Have at least one person here to look after it?
Yeah, I'll talk to them.
Yeah,
I'll try and stay with them.
Yeah. And then this slides down really.
When I beat yourself, $35.
And then they just all sit on it and grab nothing.
Let it go.
The whole thing's designed.
See what you do? You just hold it off until they get the chariot upright, and then you drop down, you put your neck just above the axle,
and push through that.
Destroy our land, you buggers. Go on.
Yeah, you gotta drop.
How do you guys sleep at night? How do you guys bloody sleep? And your kids! Sweet fuck all! A fucking beer gut! It's not so much the cops.
It's the forest, fuckers!
The others are off and arrested where?
Under the bulldozers.
But they haven't been brought through yet, eh?
No.
They've been cut off, presumably?
They're off. They're arrested. That's why they've both got in to start work. Yeah. So. Yeah.
It's got to happen. Somebody's got to be in this pod.
They sit down and pretend they're talking to us, Steve Rayson, and then he'll tell us anything we want to hear, but whether it happens or not, you know? I mean, I live over the other side of that hill. I live here, I see all these animals. I see the river going like this every year with less and less water. With no water, we can't live out there. I have to leave my property. It's not worth what I pay for it, then.
Being shot past us, right? I want to talk, we want to talk to Steve.
Please, can we just talk to him?
Talk back to him in his office.
No.
We're at another location, not here.
Why?
That's
didn't you pass on our message that we wanted to talk to him
up here?
Why did he walk straight past us?
I don't know, you'll have to ask him.
He said...
Right, if you don't go, this is the last warning, unfortunately, we're going to have to start...
Where's Steve? I want to talk to Steve.
Come on. Let's go.
No, Jerry, you come with me, I'll take you home.
Come on, Jerry.
Yeah, he has been living up here for a bit.
we'll just stand out of the way.
Come on, anyone need
sorry, that was part of the negotiations this morning. Of course, you didn't agree to it. You said, hold you to talk.
I'm afraid
what
I'm
I suggest
not
you
prepared
do
to be arrested.
Is go, and, go in and see Steve Grayson and start talking to him again.
I'm going to Yeranga now.
You're going to have to talk now. To him, but
he's
unfortunately,
not
to talk to us today. But not here.
See, we've just heard the yellow-belly glider expert in the state here. He's just given us a tape to play tonight to prove that the stuff's in there.
I know
it's a piece of atrocious time. I know, I'm just letting you know what's happening here and why people are feeling so strongly about all this.
That's fair enough.
This is really stuff.
Like I said, I can't buy into that, right? I've got to stay neutral.
Fair enough.
And I don't want to go coming in and rough handling everybody. I'd rather see you just go out. Okay, but go and see him and put that to him. You've got, like I said, you won a heap of brownie points here yesterday by negotiation, by doing it the right way. Keep doing that. Okay?
Okay, no.
Rightio. Everybody else going to have to start moving along, sorry. That's why
we have one person here just to keep an eye on our friends to make sure everything's alright?
Everybody goes.
That's why they're going to be arrested.
It's just, you know, there's no female police here or anything either, so like...
Mate, we can't help
that. That's right.
Just the way it is. Doesn't matter. You're going to have to move along.
No, you don't want police liaison for their safety or anything like that.
Sorry?
A police liaison for their safety.
Emergency police rescue or anything else?
We're going to have to organise that. If something happens to them, that's our responsibility.
But you're not going to just try and pull them down without police rescue coming in to have a look or something like that, are you? Because this is dangerous, you know?
Mate, I'm not commenting on that. But
in other words, just go and then move it.
Come on. Everybody, start moving along, otherwise you're going to have no option but to start arresting.
If you roll him down, you won't get a line down.
We're going to do nothing stupid.
Hang in,
They won't come.
We'd prefer to leave someone here to keep an eye on them, you know, from our side as well, but that's not possible.
Well, as you know, they're trespassers, so
we're concerned for their safety.
Take care.
How come no one's allowed to stay here?
Legally, we've got to get out.
I've asked you nicely.
Kick ass, don't take no shit.
Smile sweeping through the bars at you.
when can we have a talk with you?
Is it going to be the same as the last one?
The policeman told us if we left peaceably, we'd be able to have a talk with you.
When all obstacles are removed.
That's got nothing to do with me.
It has with me. When all obstacles are removed and we leave the closed area, then I'm prepared to talk to people.
You never talked with us last time.
I'm also prepared to discuss with one or two people on site in my company what's going on.
I'm here as part of the Buck of Engineers Water Users Group. I'm not here as part of the forest dwellers or whatever. I'm asking you when... So
the residents have a say in it, the people that own the land that you've virtually just stopped them from walking in their backyards. It's all banned now. But you don't want to talk to
us. Steve, you haven't given me an answer yet.
You came to talk to us and you had it all written down, but you wouldn't let us have a say.
I think Steve's so bloody ashamed of himself, he can't get any words out.
Can you sleep at night either, Steve?
No.
Look at all these
cameras. Now I've been on so much bloody videos since I was in the movies.
Which point will I be delivered at?
We just said we're not going
to. But they're not under arrest.
It'll be outside the.
I want to talk about.
But they're not under arrest at this point.
I've got something totally different.
I'm just wondering about it.
They're not just going to be charged.
I don't know if they're going to be dumped out in the middle of nowhere.
Drive the truck.
Steve, you haven't given me an answer yet.
Unfortunately, he's not prepared to talk at this stage.
I'm quite within my rights to ask him to give me a time. It's all I want.
You're going to have to make an appointment another time.
Well, I don't want to leave here until he makes an appointment with me for another time. What more rights has he got than me as a human being in this forest? This is what it all boils down to, you know? None of us, even you guys, haven't got any choice. You've got no choice, we've got no choice. It just doesn't make sense.
I'm the district forester. I am an authorised officer under the Forestry Act. I am authorised to close this forest. I have closed the forest and have directed that signs be erected to this effect. You are now required to leave as you are in breach of the forestry of the regulations under the Forestry Act.
Okay. Right, are you leaving now or are you going to be arrested?
Can I
get someone to
are you leaving now or are you going to be arrested? Hold the back door.
Are you going now or are you going to
someone made hurt up there, I can hear him screaming.
He's going to talk to me Friday.
Everybody move along, otherwise you'll be arrested. The area which you have been staying is within the closed area. You are required to leave there.
I'm proud of you.
is this good?
Didn't change after the war, did it? Your parents disciplined you too much, but you kept it up.